no codes. I'm telling you, there are no codes. I swear to you, there's a new security system. It's all very high tech.
Wax in your ears, fatto! You wanna be smart? You keep your face super glued to the floor and they'll blow it off! Hey, back down! Watch him! It's your responsibility!
I don't know what happened. I swear to you, I don't know.
Get the tooth.
Unbelievable. Don't even bother. It's closed.
No! No! No!
The hell is that? Get it! Ever spend a work. Fuck! The guy's jacked up! The guy is fine. Get the bag. He was going for his gun. We took his gun. He is no threat. It's time to go.
You got the stuff?
Yes.
I'm just gonna blow this shit's head off.
You know my rules.
Really?
It's cool. Let's move out.
You're a fucking goose. Fuck you. You fucking shot me. Now I'm gonna die.
Negative 7 seconds, we're late.
Come on, come on, you've been compromised. Take care of business and let's go.
They're all witnesses.
What are you waiting for? They saw it, your face.
Let's go. Pick up the trash. Thank you.
Bloody hell.
You killed Wade, you daft cock trough! Now we got the heat on us. You should have backed him up and let him kill that bleeding guard. He's seen your face now, hasn't he? And he's not dead now, is he?
Was my call.
It's on your call. Your call makes a more dangerous situation for me, and I don't like dangerous situations for me.
Hey, we're gonna get heat because Wade, your fucking guy, was high, and you know it.
Excuse me, did I ask you?
Did I say, hey, assbag, what's on your wee mind?
Shut up and get changed. You gonna give me an explanation or not?
None needed.
Fuck you say. You have dropped us knee deep into shite, and there's no telling how many people saw your face back there.
Let it go!
I am not warning you again, fancy. God almighty, I can't believe who I'm in with, a fucking retard and a stupid key who can't even...
I'll have everything offshore in a month. 30 grand each.
What about Wayne's 30? He's not using it.
Yeah, you really sound like you miss him.
Just lay low for a month. You'll get the rest of your cut.
I've got her hat.
When haven't you, huh? Will I screw you? Yeah, I didn't think so. So just shut your face for 30.
Don't much like waiting.
Get a hobby.
Days, then I come looking for you. And you.
Hey, look, I've grown your too, you know.
Nobody saw your face, and I shot that dumb prick, so if I get popped, I go down for the job and a murder.
I couldn't have done any of this without you, Valley.
Don't fucking go there. I was out. I should have never let you get me involved in this. I told you never to contact me again.
Hey, I helped you disappear. You owe me.
I don't owe you shit.
These guys connected. This thing goes really high up.
And you trust them?
No. But I've got an insurance policy. She's flying in tonight.
So, this is how things are gonna go. I'm gonna go get drunk. Soaking it up for a couple, and you are gonna get me the hell out of the country by tomorrow night.
I've got you set up in town. Our old place. Come on. You used to love it there. I don't remember any complaints.
I have a few now.
bag.
I gotta hang on to this until I...
Not taking it. Jeez. You look like shit, by the way.
I guess you knocked the wind out of me.
Consider these an advance.
Has described to police the killer of the fourth gunman. In a CBN exclusive, we have obtained the police sketch of that suspect. I'm Peter Turney.
Yes, this is right. Yes, I know. I wanted to be.
That's better.
Certainly.
Yourself out?
Yeah.
I can take you to the front desk. They'll issue the new key card.
No need. My husband's inside. He's just a heavy sleeper.
Darling, there you are. Was she wandering around the hotel again? She does that. Thanks for bringing her home.
No problem. You folks have a nice evening.
I like this.
What?
My hair. It's good. And I love the green eyes. Yeah, the blue was a bit, I don't know, cold.
Why did you leave me standing out there?
Sorry, I was in the bathroom. Thanks for getting dressed, by the way.
I thought it was an emergency.
It is.
Yeah? Well, then you better tell me I'm getting out of here tonight.
No. But... You know that insurance I was telling you about? I think I may have found something even better. But I'm gonna need your talents to unlock it. I'm not making this up. Look, I may have lied to you about a lot of things, but not something this big. Hey, come on. Don't you remember anything good about us? About me?
You're such an asshole. You know I had to leave.
Shit, that's her. Quick, hide.
What? Why?
She's only expecting me to be here. She'll run. Just, trust me, get out of sight. Go, 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 go.
Really, Kevin? Another woman.
Jessica, come on
in. I can't. I'm so sorry. I can't.
Come on, man, let her go. She didn't do anything.
I'll what, Mr. Fuller? Check the purse, find the phone. Passcode.
I can't tell you.
And why is that?
Because once you know what's on there, I'll be useless to you, and you'll just kill me.
That is true. But I can offer you the option of a painless death. If you tell me the passcode. Was your master plan? I do hope you had the foresight to make a backup. Oh, no, you didn't, did you? Shame. I am a man who keeps his promises.
I'm sure we can make a deal.
No, I'm afraid, Mr. Fuller, that the time for deals is over. Now, you seem to have forgotten that our mutual employer has extremely long arms.
The senator can go fuck himself.
Thank you. I should take great pleasure in informing him you said so. Now, Mr. Fuller, if you tell me where the diamonds are, this night will get exponentially shorter and potentially a great deal less painful. No? All right, hurt him. Where are they, Mr. Fuller?
Nowhere at all. Fight him. Fuck it.
I'll tell you the honest truth, Mr. Fuller. I don't really give a flying fuck where those diamonds are. What I'm really interested in is the little electronic device that was stored with them. Oh. Wait, you find this funny, do you?
Yeah. Every man pictures the way he's gonna die. This is just not what I expected.
Who said anything about dying?
Oh, God. What the fuck is that? Oh, God.
Let me make this easier for you, Mr. Fuller. If you do not tell me where the bag is, I will find your family and I'll have your wife raped until she is dead. And then I will have your child sold to slavery in the very worst Dickensian hellhole I can find.
Fuck you. Fuck the senator. And fuck this bed, which is probably made in China.
Skewer his fucking shoulder. Your last chance, Mr. Fuller. You're going to talk. Everybody does. Do it again. Why does he stop moving? Wake him up.
I think he's dead.
What do you mean he's dead? No. He can't die until I say he dies. Oh, for fuck's sake. Okay. Search him for ID, see where he lives. Maybe he stashed the diamonds there. Then clean up this fucking mess.
Center.
Yo, excuse me. Save a cup of dancing, don't you? Do you have it?
Not exactly, sir, but the girl has been handled and the video has been erased.
On that front, at least you are safe.
The video is embarrassing. The drive is treason.
Yes, we'll toss the room before we leave. I'm confident we'll find it.
Speaking of overconfident, how's our friend Mr. Fuller cooperating?
Yes, Mr. Fuller, how can I say this, has checked out of this hotel.
As soon as we find his partners,
I'll call you, let you know.
Mr. Washington? Are you there?
Going on out here.
Ebola outbreak. Get back in your room.
thing. I really need to get to Oz.
Took you for a working girl. You know, wrong place, wrong time, that kind of thing. But then I found this little baby in your room. A Vector SP-1. Custom edition. Nice gun. Prose gun. So now I have to assume that you are part of Kevin's posse. Maybe even that smashing little redhead that the news services are so excited about. Kind of sloppy, though, wasn't it? Getting your face seen like that? You know, your face is vaguely familiar to me. Have we met before?
You'd have remembered me.
Maybe.
And I would have remembered that tie.
Right now? I think my tie is the least of your problems.
I'm gonna blow his head off!
She's good. Really fucking good. Let's go down.
Clever, but I've seen this in far too many movies. But that is it, Rappen. Go back up.
On the Sky Bridge, headed for the parking.
Thanks.
like this woman.
Goddamn head in. Who is it?
It's me. Let me in.
You had a goddamn mind coming here.
Just let me in. Please.
Oh, that's new. I don't think I've ever...
Quiet. Open the goddamn door.
That's more like it.
Choke on it, you dumb bitch.
Hey, you want to make 10 grand for pressing a button? Open the damn door. Let me in.
10 grand?
Yes. Let me in and I'll give it to you.
Show it to me.
There's no time.
I'm counting.
They're after me.
Who's after you? You didn't bring the gobshite cops here, did you?
No, the fucking cleaners. Serious goddamn cleaners.
Why should I help you?
Because they killed Kevin.
Get in!
Nice nose.
Cow. Here, keep it. For Kev's funeral.
Always knew you were a softie. I barricaded the door. Heavy artillery?
Not much. Just what the law allows. I dumped everything else in case you got busted. Don't worry. This'll get the job done.
Nice.
Thanks.
Need something, though.
You're right. Not sure what, though.
You going somewhere?
Well, with your face being all over the news, I thought it might be better to lay low somewhere with no extradition law.
I need your laptop.
I look like I have a fucking laptop.
Okay, a desktop, a fucking tablet, anything? Oh, please tell me you at least have a phone.
In the back.
want him to think we're hiding.
That's the only way in now.
Let him come.
Make your phone call. Me and the old bastard will take care of it.
Hello? Penny?
It's Alex.
Here, kitty, kitty, kitty.
Leave us alone.
Listen to me.
Listen to me. You stay away from my family. Is that piece of shit with you?
No, he's not. He'd be with you. You can keep him.
Listen to me.
You and your kid are in danger. You need to get out.
What have you gotten him involved in? Shut up!
Look, Kevin has a secret hiding place.
Don't you worry. Daddy's home. He's got a lovely fish dinner for you.
He keeps things in there. I'm sure he told you about it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know exactly what I'm talking about. Now, there's enough there to take care of you forever. There should also be a package for me.
My husband is out of your kind of business.
Hey, you like the house you're living in?
Where do you think you got the money for it, huh? Oh my God, that bank yesterday, that was you two. You promised me. Look. Just take what's in there and bring the package to me. I am not bringing you anything. God, this isn't about you and me anymore. He is my husband, not yours. He chose me, so get over it and leave me alone. God damn it.
Put the phone down. Come on.
You gotta have another piece.
Nothing. Shh. I got it. Come on in, fellas. Join the party. Let's go!
Behind you!
Was subtle. Where's your sense of fucking finesse, huh? Come on, get out, Dunkoff.
Hello.
And what's your name?
Matthew Michael Fuller.
Well, hello, Matthew Michael Fuller. My name is Mr. Johnson. I'm calling from the telephone company. You sound like you're a very big boy.
Yes, I am almost six.
Six, really? Wow, that is old. And are you a clever boy, Matthew?
Mm-hmm.
Yes? Well, let's see just how clever you are, shall we? I'm going to give you a little test, all right?
Go.
Do you know your full address?
7415 Glen Avenue.
Oh. You are clever. Well done, Matthew.
You want to know anything else?
No, no, that's quite all right for today, Matthew. If ever I should meet you, I'm going to give you a very big prize.
Okay, nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you. Bye-bye. All right, I know where she's heading.
Let's move out. Tell Miss Clinton to get her ass in gear and join us.
God, Kevin, what did you do? Do you want some food? Come. How about some crunchy choco vampire guys?
Yeah.
Matthew, didn't I tell you to put your toys away last night?
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Hurry up and eat. Mommy needs 5 minutes. We're gonna go on a trip today, okay?
Yep.
Hey, babe. How you doing? I'm downstairs. Grab your helmet. Come on.
Hey, come back here.
Matthew, I need you to get dressed right now. Hurry. Matthew. Maddie. Matthew. Thank God, Matthew, we have to go.
There's someone outside.
What?
I think they want to come in.
Early bird, etc., etc.
Maddie!
Maddie! That's what we're looking for.
Maddie, I'm scared!
Yes.
Maddie!
One moment. Matthew, there's a grown-up on the phone. Don't be rude. What's the situation back at the hotel?
We've made pretty good time. We're ready to dispose of the garbage.
I'll be back in 10 minutes. Could you clean up here?
No problem. And the woman?
Do with them what you will.
Dad, where's my daddy?
Tragic. Goodbye, Matthew.
We have a few minutes to kill, so to speak.
I like that. I'd like to spend a few minutes with her.
Yeah, right, new guy. You handle the kid. Go get him.
Come here, kid. Down from there, kid.
Santa's not up there. Do you think this is a game?
I do.
Come on, baby.
you're newly single, I'm gonna enjoy this.
Come on. Hey, big man. You look all right. I don't want to see this.
What? Me killing you?
No.
But you're my ball partner.
I know what you're thinking. I took that idiot in the other room. I can take this guy, right? Right? Drop it. Drop it. Ouch. Foreplay. Drop it. Oh, you want to play? Oh. Let's play.
Yes.
Good morning, Mr. Washington.
Oh, good morning, sir.
My apologies for hanging up so abruptly on you earlier. We've had something of a trying day.
Never mind that. Do you have the drive?
Yeah, we may have hit a little
bit of a snag
in that department, sir.
Don't bullshit the bullshit, sir. You had Mr. Fuller in hand 7 hours ago. What
went wrong?
One of Fuller's associates. She's highly trained, possibly ex-military.
Suppose I should thank you for coming back for us. It's what Kevin would have wanted. Or even, you just saved my life.
Yes, I did. Ironic, considering all the times I wished you dead.
Kevin wanted to get out.
No, he didn't. Kevin always preferred the easy way out. You know, take it instead of earn it.
These guys are gonna be back. They murdered Kevin and they will kill us too unless I kill him first. What's on the drive? No idea, but we're about to find out. Shit! We have to get out of here. They've tracked the drive, now they know where it is.
How can I help?
What about Matthew?
I can leave him with my mother.
Just a logistical thing. Nothing for you to worry about.
Politics is logistics, son, and I worry plenty. Especially about highly trained ex-military
women y'all can't seem to deal with.
Yes, I do have a plan,
sir.
Oh, good. Run it by Doug when he gets there.
Sir, I can assure you there is absolutely no need to send Mr. MacArthur. We have the situation well in hand.
Do you? Oh, good. He can use the vacation. This business has him a little upset. He's in the air now.
He should be landing in a few hours.
Yes, sir. I very much look
forward to working with him.
I hope you have a good fucking night, too. Back in 5. It's all under control, sir.
Do I detect some frustration?
How did you...
Does redial ring a bell?
You should be sure you're alone when you give away your best tricks.
So you were there. Where, may I ask?
This magician doesn't reveal her secrets.
Tell you what. I'd be a good sport and give you a head start. If I were you, I'd get out of that hotel because cops are on the way.
Look, you're not going to call the cops. Even if you were that stupid, we'd be out of this hotel before. Oh. Clever girl. Move it. She's made us. Clinton, come with me. Mr. Jefferson, stay here.
Then can we get me to the friggin' doctor? My foot feels like it's gonna fall.
Forget it.
He's right on the edge, so if you think he won't throw you in along with the garbage in the trunk, you're wrong.
Something. It's about the diamonds.
I can't talk right now. Stick with the plan.
You have to stop meeting like this. Open.
Where is he?
He probably went to take a leak.
This is what you get for hiring a half-wit. Mind your head, Kev. Undoubtedly. We have what she wants.
She wouldn't risk it.
Ah, of course she would. Talk of the devil. There you are. I missed you at the hotel.
I didn't miss you. I want my property.
No, of course you do. Diamonds are a girl's best friend, after all.
Very funny.
I aim to please. You know, this could be a mutually beneficial relationship.
Oh. Now you want a relationship, huh?
Oh, stop it. People say we're falling in love.
Yeah, love this. Give me back my diamonds.
Yeah, except they're not actually yours, are they? You know, strictly speaking, they belong to the senator.
Because the senator needs more money? I don't think so. They're mine now.
We both know the senator didn't hire us to steal the diamonds. He hired us to steal the drive.
So I'm gonna go ahead and call Kevin's murder a breach of contract and take the diamonds as compensation.
Yeah, I guess you have a point. Now, how can I get them to you if I don't know where you are?
I'll give you a hint. It's rectangular, way out of date, and it stinks. Oh,
I see. Well, if you're looking for the diamonds in that car, I'm afraid you're going to be sorely disappointed.
Not at all. Found just what I was looking for. And he'd like to say hi.
Say hello to the nice man.
Excuse me?
He said she's got a gun in my mouth.
So let's make a deal. I'll trade you this piece of shit for my diamonds. Otherwise, his head whistles.
Well, as I don't really care whether you turn him into a flute or not, I'm afraid the only deal I'm going to be doing is for the drive.
So I will give you your diamonds, as
you're so fond of calling them. You give me the drive, and we all skip away happy.
I don't negotiate. Offer's on the table. You have 5 seconds.
What? No more witty banter?
4, 3.
Bluffing doesn't suit you.
2.
Last chance.
I just don't think you're this cold.
1.
Where is she?
I didn't see her.
Why'd you let her get away?
I never saw her.
Stop that fucking horn! Oh, shit.
Damn, she's good. Now, where the hell is she?
I've no idea, but she's certainly full of surprises. I like that coat.
Ride this way, guys. Ride this way.
God damn, she's still here.
Ready, Jessica? You're gonna look just like me. Now listen, here's the plan.
I have right here in my hand what it is you want. And if you want it, you're gonna have to come and get it. Isn't it time we were properly introduced? You know, face to face?
Is this face to face enough for you?
Oh, you do continue to delight and amaze.
And you're really, really starting to piss me off.
Oh, I'm sorry. I really can't imagine why.
One more step and he takes flight.
Yeah? Then you'll come right with me.
I'm bored. Wake her up. Sorry about your clothes. Miss Clinton here was a little over-enthusiastic in her search for the drive. You care for a game?
Go fuck yourself.
Glad to see you haven't lost your sense of elegant repartee. I'm fed up playing these two. Give me a challenge.
Thought I already had.
Touché. Come on.
I don't play.
Strange. Had you pegged for a chess champ. Maybe high-stakes poker is more your thing. What with that expressive face of yours. Now, you have something I want, I have something you want. Oh, no. No, that's not quite right, is it? Because what you want is, in fact, entirely worthless. Did Kevin fuck you over, Because I know you didn't steal a bag of broken windshield glass. Now, looks as if the only thing you have left to bargain with is your life. And you should know this about me. I always get what I want. So, tell me. Where is the drive?
Fuck you.
Oh, you give me a little choice. Rick, you prepare a leg. Help me with my problem, then I can't finish my business. If I don't finish my business, then the senator doesn't pay me. The senator doesn't pay me.
But you just love to talk, don't you?
This is your final chance. Where is the drive? Okay, let's kick off with a couple of turns. Well, a couple more like that and your leg is going to be two-dimensional.
Which is one more dimension your personality will ever achieve.
Again. You know, that leg is going to pop. And when it does, it's only a matter of time before the gangrene sets in.
Green's always been my best color.
Good. Just as well, huh? Again. Come on. Tied up. Where is the drive? All right.
In front of me. If I help you, what's in it for me?
Very least, your leg. And at the most, your life.
You're right.
Come on, keep going. Nothing. Now, you really are prepared to lose your leg. You are quite the remarkable. Back off, both of you. You remind me of a story. An urban legend, perhaps. But, you know, about 7 years ago, I was doing some freelance work, shall we call it, for the agency. in Cairo. There was a great deal of chatter about a senior member of the Palestinian Authority who was coming into town for a sit-down chit-chat with some Egyptian ministers. And the word on the street was that he was to be housed in an impenetrable government-owned fortress. Now you can guess what happened. It was a massive bomb. But it was set on the inside of the building. Little birdie told me that the CIA had struck a deal, letting Mossad borrow an incredibly talented and creative entry specialist. She, for yes, indeed, it was a woman, was the very best in the world at penetrating the most impenetrable places and then poof, disappearing without a trace. I'll admit, the story has always fascinated me. Its heroine and its ultimate tragedy, for her blast did not kill its intended target, but instead claimed the lives of his three sweet young children and their poor mother. He, amazingly, escaped with only minor injuries. I've often thought about that female operative. You know, what went wrong, do you think? Was it poor intelligence, shoddy equipment, or just plain bad fucking luck? Did she feel any remorse? Or did she manage to compartmentalize the death of the mother and her three children, perhaps as a man might have done? Anyway, the long and the short of it was that the CIA dropped her as quickly as the proverbial hot brick. She threatened to go all Edward Snowden on them, and they retaliated by spinning her as a double agent slash terrorist. Oh, how the mighty fall, huh? What do you think, Alexis? Do you think such a mythical creature could possibly exist? As boy, the demons she must carry. Now, I'm gonna take a different tack here. So I could always go back and finish that other business. Kevin's wife, little Matthew in his jammies, you know. Boom. Yeah, I struck a chord, right? The feeling that you might balk at causing yet another child infinite pain. Whereas me, I have no such qualms.
Why should I believe you?
Because I don't lie. Ever.
Okay. When and where?
Western Cape Airport, tonight, 2100 hours.
I'm gonna need to make a call.
Good girl. Give her a phone.
It's going to be Cape Town Airport, 9 p.m. tonight. Hate that redial. You want to let me up now? Come on, why wait till tonight?
We Because... It's gonna take that long. For Frick here to sew you up? Oh, don't worry, it's just a flesh wound to stop you trying to run away. You know, you might want to rethink the whole chess thing. It's good for people in our line of work. This situation here, that's what we'd call check. Get her dressed. Make her look pretty. Of going any faster, Grandma? Because this really cannot be hurting this much.
Frick.
Come on, are you coming? Here's the key. Here.
Oh, you are a magician, aren't you?
Thank you. Take it.
No, I don't think so. It's not part of the deal.
Yes, it is. You get to drive, I walk away.
No, because funnily enough, I don't trust you. I know your style by now. Your friend has known about the airport all day. Who knows what nasty little surprise might be lurking behind that locker door. So, if you don't mind, I won't take the key, because you're going to need it to open that locker.
Go to hell.
Really? Excuse me, officer.
What are you doing?
Officer?
Don't.
Can I help you?
Darling?
Right. I'll do it.
Yeah, sorry, there's a unattended bag down there under the stairs. I didn't know who to report it to, so...
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Good work. Shall we?
Happy.
Check it. Make sure there's no surprises.
Trust me now?
Not now. Not ever.
Oh, fuck!
Oh, shit!
What did you...
I had to let you catch me. Otherwise, none of this would have worked.
Oh, you magnificent bitch! Oh.
I think this should be our last face to face.
You hit it on me?
That tie wasn't doing you any favors. It had to be good for something. Bishop 5. Checkmate.
You really are the stuff of legends, aren't you?
Kind of like your tie.
And people started shooting. What's wrong with this world? Schools aren't safe, airports, what's next?
So sorry.
Can I go? I'm late to fetch my son.
I have a few more questions, okay? I'd like to go through everything with the witnesses while the memory's still fresh.
Hey, Frank.
Yeah?
You gotta come see this. Now.
We've got your number, so go ahead and fetch your son. If we need anything else, we'll call you. What is it?
You're not going to believe this, but I think we got the guys that pulled the Darling Street job yesterday.
Was this it?
That's all we found.
The rest must be with the woman that ran the crew.
I don't think so, man. Check this out.
Mom? Tell Matthew I'm coming. Everything's gonna be okay.
Ah, shit.
And didn't the guard say she had some kind of scar on her face?
Jesus, this is our girl.
What kind of sick mind thinks something like this up, man? I mean, who carries a head around in a bag?
Mark this airport down. Who's in charge? In charge?
Who's asking?
We need all the evidence you have immediately.
Interpol hasn't got jurisdiction here.
I'm calling this in.
Whatever.
Here's the bag you wanted, Mr. MacArthur.
Have a safe trip.
Thanks.
Next.
Drive.
Welcome aboard flight A-362-1.
A couple days.
Do I look that bad? Sorry, it's not rough. It's cut. Like you'll be if you can't open that.
Relax. Done work for BAC. Although not voluntarily. I mean, it's badass and fucking scary, and then there's these guys.
It's going to take long?
I'm almost there. Holy shit. Seriously, what sort of trouble are you in?
We're going to engineer an event that shapes the destiny of our country. In just a few months' time, the north side of Chicago is going to make 9/11 look like Macy's Parade. And you'll get your war. And I'll get my office. It's time we took this country back from the apathetic lemmings and sycophantic dilettantes that have run it into the ground and turned the U.S. into a fucking punchline.
Who am I speaking with?
You can call me Mr. MacArthur. I was just admiring some of your handiwork.
So was I.
The Senator will hunt you to the ends of the fucking earth for that drive.
So why don't we create some terms to
arrange its return, huh? What do you say? We're both reasonable parties here.
Well, reasonable isn't the word I'd use to describe what I'm seeing.
Do you understand me?
No, you understand me.
No. I've spent 6 years hiding in the darkness. It's time to come back into the light.
I'm sorry, sir, but I don't have it. Mr. Washington and the others failed.
Have they been appropriately dealt with?
Alex saw to that for us. All other loose ends are being tied up now.
With the exception of the drive.
Alexis has it, doesn't she?
She and BAC are going to be the bane of my run.
BAC is just a bunch of greedy warmongers.
Well, sir, greed and warmongering tend to go hand in hand when dealing with defense contractors.
I suppose.
Is Alexis going to be
greedy too? Or a martyr?
Well, she already has a diamond, sir, so if I'm not mistaken, I believe that she just declared war.
A martyr, then. You know what you have to be a martyr, Doug?
No, sir.
Dead.